Airbus is in the process of considering whether to go ahead with the development of a next-generation multi-role tanker transport, or MRTT. Based on its A330neo platform, the aircraft would be a replacement to the fairly well-received A330 MRTT based on the A330-200. Is this a good idea? Let's explore the topic for today's video. As the website Breaking Defense reported, Airbus is in the exploration phase for an updated MRTT. This process includes de-risking studies to assess feasibility. The jet would be based on the A330neo, offering advancements in aerodynamics and flight control systems. If it goes ahead with the project, the European plane maker is hoping that the new offering will be market ready by the end of the decade. Maria Angeles Marti, head of tanker and derivatives at Airbus Defence and Space, was quoted as saying, "We're thinking about the A330neo. It's a very natural evolution of our tanker solution. We're going to go from the A330-200 to the evolved A330neo." While the commonality between the original and Neo platforms is high, the differences are enough to require more attention and thought before offering a new MRTT to the world. However, Airbus claims to have a quote-unquote high level of confidence in its ability to convert the A330neo into an MRTT. A significant step in the transformation from a commercial passenger platform to one for the military is the addition of hose and drogue pods for refueling probe-equipped combat aircraft. As the Airbus representative noted, the engines are different, and the wings of the A330neo are a little more flexible than the A330CO. With the first original A330CO rolling out in 1992 and the first A330neo taking flight in 2017, there are some 25 years of technological advancements between the two aircraft. While much of the A330neo has commonality with the A330CO, a lot of improvements have been made as well. These include new engines, new wings, and a new cockpit. With just 12 airframes ordered, it appears that A330-800s won't be emerging from Airbus's assembly facilities in the same numbers as other types made by the company. Optimists would argue that it's only a matter of time before big A330-200 operators decide to metaphorically pull the trigger and make a deal for the updated variant. However, many airlines have opted to replace their A330-200s and -300s with Boeing 787s. Thus, an A330neo MRTT might be the only way we'll see more A330-800s rolling off of Airbus's assembly line. But still, the MRTT market is significantly smaller than compared to the market for commercial airliners. One also needs to consider the fact that the A330 MRTT is still very new for some countries and their air forces. Thus, as with all endeavors, Airbus will need to carefully weigh the costs of development against potential sales. What do you think of the possibility of an A330neo MRTT? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.